Today on BRStv, we have our 10th episode of the Neptune Apex series. In today's episode, we're going to discuss calibrating your ORP probe. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we discuss a new topic related to reefing. This week, we're going to discuss calibrating your ORP probe. This is going to be the shortest episode ever. I'll quote the Neptune Apex manual. It is not necessary to calibrate your ORP on your Apex controller. So if you have any questions about this, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, subscribe, because we do this every... Okay, so I know you want more than that, but seriously, calibrating your ORP probe is a complete waste of time and money in almost every case. The calibration solutions often cost more than the probe itself, and to some degree, you're more likely to mess things up than make them better. Thing is, ORP isn't like pH, where knowing a precise number like 8.2 tells you something. With ORP, we're really looking for ranges, trends, and large variances from these trends. For the most part, people only monitor ORP for two reasons: to control their ozone generator or set off alarms if the ORP were to fall out of normal ranges. For instance, a large downward swing could indicate a substantial drop in oxidizers because something large died in the tank. Point is, knowing if it's 340 or 360 is of almost no real value to the average reefer. If it does mean something critical to you, you need to share it with us in the comments area down below, because I'm always up for learning something new. Okay, so you heard all that and you still want to calibrate your ORP probe on the Apex? First thing you need to know is these ORP 400 solutions that are cheap and readily available cannot be used for this process, so you just forget about that. You will need to locate yourself some pH 4 and 7 solution, as well as some quinhydrone powder. It's that last part that's hard to find in small quantities. I don't use this stuff, so it's hard to tell you the best place to get it, but I have seen a kit with all three items and mixing instructions at pulseinstruments.net, which is going to be like $55 with shipping. My suggestion is not to tell your spouse what you wasted your hard-earned money on. After that, it's pretty simple. Mix the quinhydrone into small amounts of 4 and 7 pH solutions until it no longer dissolves. You can't really put too much in. Only negative related to using too much is you just wasted some of your $55 powder. Similar to the pH calibration, go to the setup menu and select ORP setup, then ORP calibration. It'll say quin 7 settling. Swirl your probe around in the solution a few times and wait for the settling number to stop changing. Once it stopped for 10 to 20 seconds, hit OK. It'll then say quin 4. Slide your probe in, swirl it around, and wait for the settling number to stabilize. Once it doesn't change for 10 to 20 seconds, hit OK and you're done. All jokes aside, I'm sure there are some legit needs to calibrate your ORP probe out there. So if you've done this or thinking you want to, share your thoughts on this with the community in the comments area below. If this is your first time with us, subscribe, because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.